Thank you, Program Director. Comrade Maite Gwanamashabana, member of the NEC of the ANC and the Women's League. Comrade Enver, our Deputy Minister of Education. Comrade Mpo, the Executive Mayor, leadership of the ANC in all its formations, the provincial, the regional, the branches, leaders of the Women's League in the same way, members of the Youth League, Mayanga Yanga, the Ambassador of Palestine, His Excellency, our Bishop, our Alliance Partners, SACP, COSATU, SANCO, the leadership of BDS, and all comrades who are here. Indeed, it is an honor to be here. Alala bujanalo halala. Alala bukoni buprima halala. Dumelang bakhet. I'm very honored to be here to speak at this gathering, the Palestinian Solidarity, and give the Palestinian Solidarity Lecture in the long tradition of solidarity across the world with the Palestinian people. As we all know, Palestine was a peaceful land where the majority of Palestinians lived with the minority of the Jewish people side by side in peace, until, as you heard, the problem started with the Balfour Declaration and with the League of Nations granting Britain the mandate over Palestine, and of course neighboring states as well. And of course, after the World War II, we know that more Jewish settlements increased, and that increased tensions. And we also know that the British then decided they no longer wanted to pursue their mandate over Palestine. They handed over the matter to the UN. By 1947, the UN, after deliberations, recommended the partitioning of Palestine into two states, a Jewish state and an Arab state. Thus, in 1948, the State of Israel was established. Fast forward, I would say that, comrades, in 1967, the Israeli government, against international law, invaded neighboring territories, including West Bank, Gaza, and East Jerusalem. The United Nations at the time passed the resolution 242, which called for the immediate withdrawal of the occupied territories. But to date, these territories remain occupied, and the State of Israel has not complied with the UN resolutions. It is with this background and understanding that we remind ourselves that the Pan-African struggle against slavery and colonialism has always recognized the universality of struggles for freedom against racism and oppression. So the struggle of the Palestinian people is part of these universal struggles. And then the newly independent African states were therefore amongst the key movers for the Banjul Conference, and the Banjul Conference resolved on the need for solidarity amongst oppressed peoples everywhere. So we would be failing not only as South Africans, but also as Pan-Africanists, if we did not support the struggle of the Palestinian people. The founders of the OAU, especially President Gamal Abdel Nasser of Egypt and President Ahmed Bembele of Algeria, strongly advocated for the solidarity with the Palestinian cause and amongst liberation movements in Africa and the Middle East. After the Six-Day War of 1967, the OAU and African independent states actively got involved in the movement to support the Palestinian people's right to self-determination and also to gain back the occupied territories. Between 1967 and 1973, 29 African countries broke relations with the State of Israel. During the same period, many recognized PLO as the authentic representative of the Palestinian people and established relations with it. This solidarity continues up to today, with a decision by the OAU and carried over to the African Union, first to invite the Palestinian representatives or Palestinian president to address the AU summits. Even in this last summit in January, the president of Palestine was there addressing the summit. But also, every summit, there is an assessment of the Palestinian situation, and it's reported, it's a standing item on the agenda of the AU to report on what's going on in Palestine. So the African Union's policy positions based on its declaration, one, reaffirms African support to the Palestinian people's quest for the restoration of their legitimate rights to establish an independent state coexisting peacefully with the State of Israel. Reiterates Africa's wish for the peaceful resolution of the Arab-Israeli conflict in accordance with principles of international law and all relevant United Nations resolutions, and with the support for the two-state solution which Palestine and the Palestinians support. Consistently calls for the resumption of negotiations between the two sides to reach a just, comprehensive, and lasting peace in the Middle East. Condemns the continued occupation and annexure of Palestinian lands and the destruction of their homes, which undermines the very foundation of the peace process. Africa, in the strongest term, condemns the human rights abuses inflicted on the Palestinian civilian population, including arbitrary arrests. The African Union must continue, just as the world must continue, to advocate that the UN Security Council must shoulder its responsibility in maintaining international peace and security. As member states, we must actively monitor and hold accountable the implementation of the UN resolution, such as the last resolution taken to Resolution 2334 of December 2016, and guard against Israeli continued aggression, breach of international laws and protocols, as well as non-implementation of UN resolution. We must put pressure first to the United Nations to take the necessary step to resolve the Arab-Israeli conflict in all its aspects. The UN must continue all efforts to achieve a just, comprehensive, and lasting peace based on the principle of a two-state solution according to the 1967 borders. Comrades, apart from the continental perspective, the issue also has very specific ramifications for South Africa. For instance, this country gave refuge to many Jewish people from Europe who faced persecution throughout the tumultuous 20th century. Many of them became critical part of the South African trade unions, the Communist Party, the Congress movement, and the ANC. And they joined the struggle because they saw in it their own personal experience of oppression and persecution. So South Africa's liberation movement and the PLO were also united by their common struggles for freedom and self-determination. Among some of the appearances, the Comrade O.R. and Comrade Yasser Arafat made in 1992, Comrade O.R. reminded the world, and I quote, "Anything that is injurious to any section of humanity is harmful to all humanity. And any order that is not freely and collectively worked out and voluntarily accepted by all cannot be just and long-lasting." He continued to say, "The unconditional upholding of the right of the Palestinian people to self-determination must be an essential condition for a comprehensive settlement of the Middle East conflict, including Israel's withdrawal from occupied Arab territories and the security of all states in the region, including the state of Israel," close quote. So it is very clear, comrades, that the Palestinian struggle is a just struggle, and an injury to the Palestinian people is an injury to humanity. And all humanity must come together and support the Palestinians and their struggle and pressure Israel to sit and negotiate and withdraw from the occupied territories and ensure that there is a viable Palestinian state. Of course, in South Africa, after 1994, recognition of the specificity of our history and our commitment to the two-state solution, at that time, the decision was taken by the democratic government not only to recognize PLO but maintained diplomatic relations. Comrades, in September 1993, under the leadership of late PLO leader Yasser Arafat and the late Israeli Prime Minister Yitzhak Rabin, the two parties negotiated in Oslo and signed what is known as the Oslo Accord. This was the closest breakthrough in the Middle East peace process. The Oslo Accord saw both parties agree on a strategy and framework of the resolution of the occupied territories. It also saw the PLO denouncing terrorism and recognizing Israel's right to exist in peace. Most notably, under this Oslo Accord, was the agreement that the Palestinian Authority would assume governance responsibilities in the West Bank, in Gaza, over 5 years period, whilst permanent status talks would begin to resolve the issues of borders, refugees, and East Jerusalem. I'm quoting this because it shows that it is possible when there is a political will to sit, negotiate, and if the two could agree according to the Oslo for the withdrawal of Israel from the occupied territories, that is possible. But what is the problem today is that Israel is not only not withdrawing from the occupied territory, but settlements are growing all the time. So it is therefore unfortunate that this process was never seen through. And we have been, and everybody who loves peace has been deeply concerned since the collapse of the Oslo process of the deteriorating situation, the expansion of settlements, the violation of human rights and human rights treaties, the Geneva Convention, the protocols of treatment of civilians and prisoners of war, and the fact that despite numerous attempts, genuine peaceful negotiations have not been on the agenda for more than a decade now. So it is for this reason that the international community and the solidarity movement, of which BDS is part, have decided to look at other tactics, because what had happened before hasn't worked. So that's why now they've looked at BDS to pressure and increase pressure to end occupation, to end the expansion of settlements, and to act against human rights abuses. The Alliance Summit in Ekurhuleni in 2007 called for all segments of the South African society to mobilize solidarity with the Palestinian people and for all a peaceful resolution of that conflict, which is not a religious conflict. It's a conflict, it's the right for determination for the Palestinians. It's the right of the Palestinians to have their own viable state. So this week of solidarity with the Palestinian people is part, obviously, of building this broad movement of solidarity. We must continue to conscientize, galvanize our people about the situation in the Middle East, ensure that we are doing our part as part of the progressive forces to advance the struggle for freedom and self-determination of the people of Palestine. As one of our comrades said here, the entire world came together. The people of the world came together to support us in solidarity with our struggle. So as South Africa, we cannot but support the Palestinians and show solidarity and mobilize all South Africans, Africa and the world to support Palestine. And as we debate tactics, including towards the ANC policy conference in June this year, we must ensure that our solidarity is conducted in a manner that is disciplined, like we are, inclusive and principled, that furthers the legitimate cause of Palestinian people, promotes dialogue, and does not allow racism, discrimination, violence, and anti-Semitism from any quarter. South Africa and the world has a responsibility towards the Palestinian people, and we must ensure the spirit of dialogue, peace, and solidarity with the oppressed of Palestine prevails. We must also reflect on the fact that the conflict and their occupation affects women and children even more. And it is therefore important that we South African women, and I'm happy that the youngers are leading BDS, because this affects women and young people even more in Palestine. And the Pan-African movement has countless examples of people and countries that you don't have to have a lot to show solidarity. A lot of people in Africa and across the world who were poor, who may have had their own problems, but they did their best to support the struggles of those who, unlike themselves, were not yet free, including the support of the South African people's struggles against apartheid. So we all have the capacity and the possibility to support the Palestinians. The ANC will remain a committed ally to the struggle of the Palestinian people. As one comrade also said, the ANC has never failed in its conference to reflect on the situation of the Palestinian people. Even in our last conference, we had a resolution. And that resolution in part calls on the ANC to continue its solidarity efforts in supporting a just solution, including the strengthening of a sovereign independent state of Palestine, which will help bring peace to the region and the conflict between Israel and Palestine. In fact, the resolution of that conflict will contribute a lot to peace in the world. It will not just be a resolution of a conflict there, but it will be a contribution to peace elsewhere. The ANC also called upon the Israeli government to release all political prisoners, to cease expansion of settlements in the West Bank, and to stop the wanton and consistent attacks on Palestinian people in the Gaza Strip. The ANC also, in the same resolution, called for South Africans to support the programs and campaigns of the Palestinian civil society, which seeks to put pressure on Israel to engage with the Palestinian people to reach a just solution. Of course, this year marks 70th anniversary of the Palestinian catastrophe, Nakba, which resulted in the dispossession of land from Palestinians through the systematic colonial expansion and military occupation. The ANC in its conference this year must continue to advance the struggle of the people of Palestine and for peace in the Middle East. But we must also note with concern that the Middle East peace process seems to have fallen off the international agenda. It's not on the radar screen of the international community. And so we must make sure that we intensify all efforts so that the matter remains on the top of our international agenda at all times. As our international icon, President Nelson Mandela said, I quote, "We know too well that our freedom is incomplete without the freedom of the Palestinians," close quote. So what does that mean when President Mandela says our freedom is not complete, is incomplete without the freedom of the Palestinians? So it means our struggle has not ended and will not end until Palestinians have their own viable state side by side with Israel in the two-state solution. We must therefore continue to do all in our power to achieve this, so that we can complete our own freedom, because our own first president of this democratic country said our freedom will not be complete until the Palestinians are free. So we have an obligation, not only to the Palestinians, but to ourselves, to complete our own freedom. So what we are doing is not an act of charity. It's an act of struggle for ourselves and for the Palestinians. So we mustn't see it as a favor to the Palestinians. And a favor is something you grant or you do not grant. A favor is something that you may grant or withdraw. It's not a favor. It's part of our struggle to see that the Palestinians are free, to see that the women in Palestine live in peace, to see that those children grow up as children in Palestine, go to school, they play freely like all our children. So comrades, we have a responsibility, and thanks for leading us in Bujanala. Forward with the struggle of the Palestinian people, forward. Forward with the struggle of the Palestinian people, forward. Long live the spirit of international solidarity, long live. Long live the spirit of international solidarity, long live. Matla. Matla. Malibongwe. Malibongwe. Malibongwe.